What's going on, guys? Today, we're going to be talking about the DJI Mavic Pro. Now that the new DJI Mavic Platinum's out, we're going to be discussing whether the Mavic can still hang with the big dogs. Alright, before we get into the details about what the DJI Mavic Pro can do, let's take it out for a test drive. I'll show you some footage that I've shot in the past, as well as some photos, and you can get an idea of just the quality of the video. So let's get into that. Alright, now that you've seen what the DJI Mavic Pro is capable of, today I just want to quickly cover three things that come to mind for me, at least, with the DJI Mavic Pro. And this is really what comes to mind for me as far as all my camera equipment goes, and that's going to be price, quality, and then usability. So starting off with price, when I purchased the DJI Mavic Pro, I did purchase the Fly More package, which came with the drone itself, two additional batteries, the controller, and then a carrying case, which as far as the overall build quality of the carrying case goes, it is nice. However, I find that I don't use it all that often because one, it kind of looks like a purse. So if I'm carrying it around, I get some strange looks. And another thing is that when I'm using the bag, sometimes it gets stuck in a weird way and getting the drone out can be a little bit difficult. With that said though, all of that came in to about $1,300 of cost, considering the drone itself with the Fly More package. However, with the new DJI Mavic Pro Platinum, I think that's the name of it. I'll have to check myself when I'm editing this to see if that's correct. With that being released, and I think taking the price mark, pretty much replacing the same price of the DJI Mavic Pro, the DJI Mavic Pro that I use, the price has dropped to $760 for the drone itself. And my first thought is that that is a great deal for someone who's a, whether you're a beginning photographer or videographer, or someone who's just really starting out. I mean, for $760, this is an extremely, extremely capable drone with an extremely capable camera. So it definitely checks my first thought when it comes to price. Next on our list is going to be quality. Now, you did see a little bit of a footage that I took today, as well as some footage that I've captured from my travels in the past. That should be somewhat of a testament of just how great a camera that this little drone can produce. It does shoot 4K. I know 4K is the big rage right now. If something doesn't shoot 4K, most people aren't going to want to buy it. 4K isn't everything, but this having the capability to do that, I think it almost future proofs your footage. And so down the road, when things finally make the transition to all really moving to 4K and that becomes more mainstream, that's going to be in your benefit down the road. As far as image quality goes, I think it's second to none. The stability is fantastic with the gimbal. I mean, for the size of the camera on the drone itself, it's pretty impeccable. I'll throw the specs up, and I don't really care about specs a whole lot. For me personally, as it just comes down to what the image looks like when I go to edit it in post. As far as stills go, it does shoot in JPEG and RAW photos, and I'll throw some up on the screen right now. And as you can see, the photos are just really second to none. I mean, I have some print, I have one printed right there on my wall that I display, and the image quality for the size of the drone is just pretty impeccable, especially at the price that it comes in at. I know I keep going back to the cost, but it really is an inexpensive cost for a drone that's as good as it is. The third and final thing, which is really what's going to be most important for me, because when I'm on a shoot, and whether I'm just filming for myself or just for fun, or I'm on an actual paid shoot, usability is something that is so, so important to me. The fact that the drone is the size that it is, I'm 6'4", so I'm a bigger guy. It does fit in my hand, and it can pretty much fit inside your pocket. okay, maybe not literally fit inside your pocket, but the size of the drone is just, it's mind-blowing that it performs as well as it does in such a small package. So the usability definitely, it impresses me continuously as to the amount that it can do in the size that it comes in. If you guys did like this video, please hit that like button. This is my second tutorial on the channel, so hopefully you guys are enjoying these. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Logan Strong Arms. I post a lot of really cool photos and videos there, so go on and check that out. That would really mean a lot. If you guys have any suggestions, I've already gotten a few suggestions on my last tutorial about future tutorials that I should do. If you have any other suggestions, please let me know in the comment box below. I will be happy to make those. I'm having a really good time, really fun time filming these. Hopefully I can gain some more traction in the future and continue to make these and produce some cool videos for you guys. I'll be traveling here soon. I can't tell you where yet. It's kind of secretive. But just know that stay tuned for some really cool travel videos on my channel. And yeah, again, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for support, and I'll see you guys next time.